This is a production of PBS 39.
Good evening. Thanks so much for joining us. I'm Amy Burkett. There are nearly 4 million homeowner insurance policy holders in the Commonwealth. But did you know that according to a recent study, almost 2 out of 3 U.S. homeowners are underinsured? When you buy a house, insurance is par for the course. But how do you make sure you're getting the most for your money and you're getting enough insurance? Crystal Fisher has some helpful hints.
Smoke alarms and security cameras can only do so much to protect your home. Are you prepared if there's a break-in or a flood? When was the last time you asked yourself, what's the most important thing in my house?
Well, definitely my daughter. She's the most important thing, you know, and I guess personal items, you know, that have value to us, you know, as a family.
But how do you keep your jewelry and family pictures safe?
Homeowners insurance is really a promise to the person purchasing the insurance that if something happens to your home, if you've paid your premium, that will be taken care of.
Jackie Porter feels at ease when she tucks her youngest daughter into bed at night, knowing that her home's protected by both an alarm and insurance.
Homeowners insurance is just one thing I have to not worry about. I was referred to someone from a friend.
I think that's the absolutely best way to get information about an insurance company so that you know about service as well as cost.
Jackie bought this two-story twin last August and went with the cheapest but most reliable insurance policy she could find. Her one main concern...
Definitely the cost of the policy was number one. To go with a company that I've actually heard of.
Lighting her stove to cook dinner for her daughter, she knows she has to cover basic accidents like fire and crimes like theft. But cost was a big issue for this single mom.
I just wanted the best sort of value for my money.
A good rule of thumb for people is to make sure and shop around to at least 3 insurance companies to find your best price.
Cindy Philman works for Pennsylvania's insurance department. She stressed the importance of frequently shopping around your policy and comparing companies, once a year if possible, especially if you've added on to your home.
If you build an addition, you should also have the house reassessed because then it's worth more and you would only get the value up to which you insured your house initially.
Also, make sure the company and your agent are licensed. Don't blindly trust internet pop-ups. It's always a good thing to ask a friend for advice. And most importantly, figure out if you have enough coverage.
Other things that tend not to be covered in the most basic personal property protection are collectibles. So if you have musical instruments, or if you have jewels, or if you have furs, or you know, rare coins, or whatever you think is particularly valuable, you need to specially purchase insurance for those things.
Roland Kushner teaches business and economics classes at Muhlenberg College, so he pays close attention to signing contracts. He also owns 2 homes.
Every person who owns a home has to make their own assessment of how risky their situation is. Now, if there's some risks that everybody faces a risk of fire. Not everybody faces a risk of flood, for example.
What you need to have for your dwelling itself is clearly replacement cost. That is up to the value that the house is assessed at. In fact, many mortgagers will not provide you a mortgage unless you are insured up to 80% of your replacement cost.
Roland and his wife enjoy their brief moments of downtime with their dogs because they're busy working and remodeling a second house. They have insurance on both, but each one is a little different. The main difference is what's inside.
Some people underinsure, some people overinsure. So enough is that if you have a loss, that you're made whole. So how much you need to make you whole depends on what you own and depends on what kinds of risks you're willing to take.
Take pictures of your contents, the things that you own, so that if there's a dispute, for example, over the value of a television set or a dining room table, you have that picture to show what the value is if there's a fire that burns everything to the ground.
Aside from fire, know if your area is prone to certain kinds of natural disasters that wouldn't normally be covered in basic policies. For example, you may want to consider adding flood insurance.
It makes a lot of sense, if you can, to purchase sinkhole insurance because that's a common occurrence because of the geology of the Lehigh Valley.
Understanding common occurrences in your backyard plays a big role in how you pick an insurance policy. Walking into their futures, both Roland and Jackie feel safer knowing they've got the right insurance policies should they ever need them. For Tempo, I'm Crystal Fisher reporting.
Support for Tempo is provided by
building a workforce system called PA CareerLink Lehigh Valley. Training the workforce to meet employer hiring needs. Connecting employers with workers and workers with jobs. Lehigh Valley Workforce Investment Board.
RCN and RCN4, partnering with PBS 39 and committed to bringing quality local television programming to the residents of the Lehigh Valley. RCN, cable, phone, and internet.
And by the members of PBS 39, thank you.